What's up, y'all? So today for this vlog, So today for this vlog, I will be showing you a little behind the scenes of what I gotta do for my clothing brand. I will be showing you packaging, because I do have to package some of the new merchandise. Then I do have to run some orders out today, and I have to ship some orders out today. So with that being said, enjoy. How you doing, everybody? So first of all, thank you for all the love, support. I appreciate you for watching this vlog. Second, in this vlog, I will be showing you behind the scenes of what I do for my clothing line. So basically today, I just will be going through a few packaging. I do have to drop off.
With this huge shit that's going on, all this crazy stuff that's going on.
We have to drop off some orders today, and I do have to ship out some orders today. So stay tuned. Let me also show you what the new sweatsuits do look like. So with the limited edition birthday bundle box, I did decide to switch it up and do an embroidery theme. The embroidery theme just brings the design to life and enhances it and shows great detail. Overall, I would say this is one of my favorite drops so far. So where I failed to check at is see if we had packing. Luckily, I'm going to a store, so I'm gonna go get that. And I'll see you guys back at the house. So basically for packaging clothing, what I did is I ordered some of these things. It's like clear wrap that packet chick, which I use for my clothing. You can use anything else. I also have like size stickers and packaging tape. And I also did order a bundle of boxes that I will be using. So, enjoy. So, let's get right into this.
With the niggas that I know and ride with me, I lost cousins to these streets that make my high different. I left Ike around some pounds when the job missed. I put my bitch on Jazz Spotter, she even fly different. 30 pair of Miri G's, I say my fly different. Even though I'm rich, I'm still left run, so why my guys tripping? I know y'all miss me, I miss y'all too, but I'm out the shy with it. Whoever thought the bitch we slept around was scandalous. If you gon' cheat on him, don't cheat on him with the fellas. I'm around millionaires, I'ma change, let them tell it. Everybody around me, gang, we rebel.
So adding the finishing touches to the sweatsuits. Just about finished, didn't take too long. So these little stickers that I got are from Zazzle. It costs like probably like 5 for a pack of 20. Great value though. I'm trying to see if you can see it. Since it was a birthday bundle, I did add a little cake and a snowflake for the wintertime, you feel me? So I just finished packaging the latest sweatsuits. If you want, you can find them on shopschemer.com or scheme_wear. But other than that, let's get to doing some drop-offs. What's up, guys? So in this part of the vlog, I will be talking about a few questions that I did get on my Instagram story. Basically, I put out a questions box to ask a few questions. I did put out a questions box to ask a few people about their questions of me owning a clothing brand. And I wanted to share my experiences and basically just, you feel me, give out some information, some free game of what it's like So we're going to talk about the process. So the process basically starts off with finding designs. I just try to send out little question boxes on my Instagrams to see what other people are like, what they are expected or want to expect to see in the next or future drops, just to get the idea. Because if you're not listening to your supporters, then you really won't have any supporters because you're not giving them what they want. You feel me? So that's the biggest aspect I really try to take away. Second, I really would just say is about finding the type of material and where to find it. Because sometimes certain stores don't have the stock that I need or that I want during the time and moment. So that may cause me to switch up my designs or cause me to switch up what I would have coming out next. So it's just all about planning and preparation and getting everything dialed in for when you want it next. Third, I would basically say is finding out how I would like to get these designs applied to materials. So they have different types of designs. They have screen print, DTG, embroidery, such, and varies in styles. You feel me? So just finding out the best way to complement the designs that you do have, that's another factor in putting the designs on. Also, packaging is very important when you own the clothes brand. It kind of just presents the professionalism and time and effort that you do into your craft. So if you're investing into, let's say, business cards and bags, boxes, etc., you feel me, just to make things a little more neat and not so just, you feel me, out the box, it just gives it the sense of you care about them. So, and that's one thing customers love. They love to feel cared about. They don't ever want to see that their product is just, you feel me, coming on with lint or anything. So I always try to always lint my clothing too, just so you can see it. I probably could see that in the last clip, but always try to make sure my clothes is clean, neat, you feel me, fold them in a nice manner, package them, put little size stickers on them, you feel me, just to have that professionalism towards it. What I would say next is part of the process is finding an actual release date. Release dates are very important because timing is important, you feel me? So if you could come out with something on a specific time, that's perfect. But depending on, you feel me, what Corona's happening now, it's kind of a little harder to just get a set time or set date that you want to drop certain things because you have limited resources. So that's basically the process. The second question I had are, what are my biggest obstacles? My biggest obstacles are the material at first, finding where's the most valuable, where's the most reliable material that I could find local or that I could depend on for the fact of the matter. So just finding the best type of material to depend on, finding the, how I would get it on, how I would, feel me? I've kind of got to the gist of, okay, I'm getting used to this business helping this bit. I'm getting used to this business starting to help with the production of clothing. But yeah, I would say that's for the most part. The most part is just finding the material and making sure that it's reliable for the supporters. You feel me? So anybody who supports, I just always try to listen out for what they want to hear, what they want next. You feel me? Because if you listen to your supporters, you feel me, they're going to support you. So, where are good distributors? What are good distributors? I mean, that all depends on the type of clothing that you want to get. There are good, sweatpants distributors, depending on the type of material for the sweatpants. Right now, I'm only using one, but I am going to try another vendor very, very soon with our next drop, which will be happening next month. So stay tuned, because February, I will be having something coming out. I'm not too definite on the release date. It is from February, but just know we're going to have something coming in February. But other than that, some good distributors. I know Suntees is a good one. All Day Shirts, S&S Active Wear. And I do have some overseas vendors. a lot of vendors do comment on my pages too. So if you do or are looking for vendors to maybe acquire a different type of style of clothing or pattern, look on my page. You will see a couple of vendors commenting under to persuade me to do business with them. Okay, so that's where you can find your help at that too. But other than that, thank you guys for watching this. Like, share, subscribe. Shop Schemer.